And we are back. This time I'm going to show you how to create a scribble effect in Adobe Illustrator. Let us activate the type tool, type in some random text. We will resize that holding shift and alt. And I use a font that's very big. This one is already thick as a regular version, but you can also use a text and make it bold. Let us copy that, holding alt and I drag copies out of it. Let me select the first one, then go to effect, stylize and scribble. Click on preview to see what you're doing, and we will start with the default. And you can go through the list. But let us adjust it manually. The path overlaps, you should adjust them. In the end, when you work with text, don't use big sizes. Go down with the spacing and the line options. You should keep the variation small as well. And now you can work on the path overlap, and you should go down to inside. And you can adjust the angle, obviously. So this is best practice when you work with text. Let me apply some more default presets. We've got, for example, this one, Noiré. I hope I pronounced it correctly. But this is a good one for text effects. It always looks good. And there's another one that looks good on text. Which is the tight option. This one. But you cannot just apply it to text, you can apply it to shapes as well. So let us create some basic shapes. For example, a cube. I used a rectangle tool and hold shift for that. And a perfect circle, I use the ellipse tool once more, hold shift. I select the cube first. Once again, effect, stylize, scribble. And we want to use zigzag. This one really looks good on these basic shapes. And let us apply another default setting on the circle. You can see that tight, it would work. When you now use the Moiré effect, it doesn't look that good. Dense is another one that always looks good on basic shapes. And this is how you can use the scribble effect in Adobe Illustrator. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.